Hey guys, okay, so I'm just gonna do this as fast as I can. I listened to a new thing that Get Fit Gamer, Chris, Avidex, whatever he goes by. Here's his name, his YouTube name right here, and there'll be a link somewhere around there to his channel. Great thing about these new audio cast things he's doing is that you can more or less put it on, you can go do some sit-ups. I took a shower while I listened to this one. In other words, you can go do something productive while you're listening to what he has to say. As we all know, the man has a golden voice. Screw the mac and cheese, homeless guy. Chris is what's up. Anyway, so let's get this going. Today in his video, Keeping on Track, Balance, Knowledge, and Motivation, he talked about a couple of different things that I would like to expand on or comment on. First of all, I would like to say congratulations on the muscle mass gain. I think it's great whenever people start doing strength training. Strength training is really something that's helped me personally go from a lot more of a squishy person to, you know, a woman with, you know, guns. I mean, like, I can handle my own. I've enjoyed building muscle mass myself, so I am just so happy that that's happened for you. Second point I'd like to come to is, who is this girl that's telling you that your face is looking thin? Because that means that somebody's been looking at you mighty close in the face, and I just want to know if I have something to worry about. Moving right along. Chris was talking about how you end up knowing so much that you get bogged down. You know what you're supposed to be doing, and then when you don't do it, you feel like a failure. At least that's the way I get. So I understand what he's saying about too much and how he slowly weaned his way onto like the raw foods thing, and how sometimes it's just the baby steps. I think it's like he said, it's important to still have a few things that aren't the best from time to time. Why? Because like he said, you're gonna come to a point where you're like, oh my gosh, I haven't had, you know, birthday cake icing in a long time. I can have a little bit. Not me, not me. I'm like a crackhead. You give me like one tiny bit of icing of a cookie or something, and it's on like Donkey Kong. I am like out at Krispy Kreme late at night. I do believe that slow incorporation of better habits is the best way to really begin to lose weight. I get this question all the time. Jill, how did you start losing weight? What did you do? Because people want a recipe. People want a recipe for weight loss, and there's no such thing as a recipe for weight loss. So what do I tell people? Honestly, I didn't know anything about calories. I knew that you're supposed to eat healthy, but I really didn't know what that was. I had been eating fast food multiple times a week. You know, I was barely physically active. So is what I personally started doing is I just started with exercise. I started off 3 days a week, and I slowly worked myself up to 6 days a week. That's what I'm doing now. And through that time, my exercise has changed. Started off just light Zumba classes and things like that. Then I started running some. Then I got into Nautilus machines. Now I do free weights and P90X. You know, it's progressively gotten harder. I can long distance run. I can freaking climb trees and leap and bound, and you know, I could probably kung fu kick someone in the head. After I started just integrating a little bit of working out in, I kind of started researching. I learned for myself. I looked at what other people were eating, and I said, okay, well, I need to know, what is it? Everybody's always saying how many calories you're supposed to eat. Well, why? Like, every single thing that I had ever learned, I just began to question. So I went on a personal journey of knowledge. I sought out the answers. I asked people, and then I Googled why their answer is correct or is not correct. You cannot take what anyone says for 100%. You got to find out for yourself, and that's the only way that you're going to retain knowledge is if you actually try to learn it yourself. So I learned about calories, and I looked up Taco Bell, Nacho Bel Grande, and all their other crap that I used to love eating. I figured out that some things are just not worth putting in your mouth. I think Chris hit the nail on the head when he said that you should look at what other people are doing. Highly successful people have highly successful habits. They're more organized. They tend to have goals. They make plans to attain these goals. And they know the difference between a smart decision and a not smart decision because of the thought process. They actually sit there and think about what they're doing and how they're going to get to where they want to get to. A lot of people just say, oh, I want to lose weight. How are you going to lose weight? The key to all this is to question, to constantly change, and to consistently work towards your goal. So another thing that Get Fit Gamer talked about was movement. And I like all the things he said, doing, you know, wall push-ups and picking up boxes and doing squats and things like that. Chris, you failed to mention the easiest things, which is take the stairs, park further away. I'm a parent, so anytime I go to the playground, I play, okay? You do not need to sit there. It's an extra free workout. Your kids are playing on the playground. I go and swing on the swings. I go and do the monkey bars. I do pull-ups. I jump off things. I get me a mini workout. Who cares who's looking at you funny, honestly? Working out at work is one of the easiest things you can do. Use your lunch break. Do something. Just keep moving. Chris also talked about how working makes him feel more successful. And I agree. If I'm not creatively thinking or producing something or making something, I feel like my life is stagnant. And when my life feels stagnant, everything goes to goo, which means I don't work out as much. So I always feel better when my stuff is clean and ordered and I am creating things and coming up with new ideas. If I'm not doing something productive, then I don't feel like I'm alive. Chris, we do need you to start painting again, and I vote that you do a contest, and I want to win the panda painting, the panda with the pink and stuff, because it is amazing. You are a very talented artist, and I would love to, you know, put your work up next to mine. So that's all I gotta say. I hope you guys enjoyed this. I don't usually do really lengthy, talky response videos, but here's one. So I love you all, and as usual, point people in this direction, rate, comment, subscribe. I love you all. Bye. Mwah.